One of the most well-liked wellness trends in recent years is gut health, and it's gained popularity as a health issue that you can't ignore. But amid online misinformation and urban legends, it can often be challenging for people to know what to believe or how to achieve a healthy gut. Everyone, from health experts to dietitians, is eager to discuss the inner workings of a healthy digestive system. Which probiotic should you be taking? Does eating fermented foods help in keeping a healthy gut? Is it true that gum can stay in your digestive system for 7 years? There are many myths and opinions about our gut that need exploring. Join us as we separate the facts about gut health from the myths. We'll talk about everything from colonics and probiotics to gluten-free diets and apple cider vinegar. Let's get started. Researchers are starting to discover that the gut microbiome is connected to various factors, including immunity, inflammatory bowel disease, mood, and metabolism. The popularity of gut health has increased due to the recent surge in interest in this new research. As you might anticipate, this has led to countless internet blogs and products producing false information that could do more harm than good. Gluten harms the digestive system. Most of us know that whole grain bread is healthier than refined wheat. Some people with coeliac disease and autoimmune illness affecting about 1% of the population must avoid gluten. In patients with coeliac disease, eating gluten causes their bodies to attack themselves, damaging their small intestine. Even more rarely than celiac disease, those with a wheat allergy must also avoid gluten-containing foods. Some people will test negative for celiac disease and wheat allergy yet still have stomach problems. Non-coeliac gluten sensitivity is the term used for this, NCGS. Even though these illnesses are not common, up to 1/3 of Americans claim they limit their gluten intake. There is no need to limit gluten for people without these disorders. Gluten-free foods frequently lack essential nutrients like folic acid, fiber, selenium, and B12. Additionally, research indicates that those who adopt a gluten-free diet are more likely to consume insufficient amounts of whole grains, which are essential for the heart. In one study, less than half of the daily required portions of grains were ingested by those on a gluten-free diet. Whole grains are prebiotic foods that won't harm your digestive system. Probiotics can repair your gut. Probiotic supplements may have some advantages, but are not a solid solution and cannot repair your gut health. The final word seems to be that some data points to the possibility that certain probiotic strains may aid in treating irritable bowel syndrome, IBS symptoms, and infectious diarrhea following antibiotic therapy. Although this is encouraging, this is not enough data to draw firm conclusions. There is currently no universal agreement on the best probiotic strains, dosages, or combinations. It's possible to improve your probiotic intake without taking pills. Fermented foods could be advantageous because they're high in beneficial microorganisms. Try including fermented foods such as kombucha, kimchi, miso, and sauerkraut in your diet. Last but not least, probiotics alone do not suffice to promote good gut health. You also need to eat a range of fruits, whole grains, and plant-based fiber. Because they're prebiotic, they feed on the good bacteria in your gut. You may want to check out the Digestive Enzymes 1000 mg if you're looking for a supplement to help your digestive system. This ultra-strength 1000 mg dose contains clinical-grade digestive enzymes and 10 billion CFU 10-strain probiotics, more than twice as much as the comparable digestive enzyme supplements. You'll get results fast. Using turmeric, ginger, papaya, pectin, bladder rack, and other organic, systemic, doctor-formulated, and plant-based ingredients to ensure the best healthy digestion for adult men and women. Anti-bloating, flatulence, fat, pancreatic, and bowel cleansing. This formula contains an advanced multi-enzyme system which aids in the digestion of fried, spicy, raw, and processed foods, dairy, protein, salts, and carbohydrates, vitamins, and an acidic diet of fruits and vegetables. This probiotic boosts immunity and relieves gas, bloating, constipation, leakiness, indigestion, reflux, belching, and acid discomfort. Stomach ulcers are caused by stress. The scientific community thought lifestyle aspects like stress were to blame for gastritis and stomach ulcers, but we know this is not the case. While stress and food can worsen symptoms, bacterial infections like Helicobacter pylori are the actual cause of stomach ulcers. We owe this discovery to two Australian researchers, Robin Warren and Barry Marshall, who shared the 2005 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine. Marshall purposefully consumed H, a classic example of a scientist putting their health at risk for scientific advancement, inflicting gastritis on themselves. Your stomach will retain chewing gum for 7 years. Even though chewing gum is meant to be chewed, not swallowed, doing so usually has no adverse side effects. According to folklore, it takes 7 years for your stomach to break down gum that's been swallowed. However, this is untrue. Indeed, your body cannot digest gum when it's swallowed. But the gum leaves your stomach as a normal consequence. It passes through your digestive system largely undamaged and is eliminated in your feces. Very rarely, children's intestines become blocked due to ingesting significant amounts of gum and being constipated. This is why it's important to prevent swallowing chewing gum, especially in children. Apple cider vinegar helps digestion. The ability of apple cider vinegar, or ACV, to enhance digestion has not been demonstrated in clinical studies. In fact, it may even make some people's acid reflux worse. Apple cider vinegar can irritate the esophagus and destroy dental enamel if it's not appropriately diluted. According to studies, ACV may shorten the time it takes for food to pass through the stomach, resulting in unpleasant sensations, including nausea, bloating, and even vomiting. Also, your potassium levels could drop too low, which is dangerous for your muscles and nerves as potassium is vital in smooth functioning. Using colonic irrigation to cleanse your digestive system. According to scientific research, colonic irrigation does not improve general and gut health. Although the colon is emptied, this is unnecessary unless you have a surgical procedure like a colonoscopy. A doctor will administer a unique laxative solution to you in these situations. Additionally, your liver and kidneys can properly handle cleansing and detoxifying your colon as they already do daily. If done improperly, colonic irrigation can cause bloating, stomach pain, infection, and even perforated bowels. Additionally, frequent colon cleansing might result in diarrhea, which depletes the healthy bacteria in your gut microbiome. Sometimes colon cleansing might be detrimental. Coffee enemas, occasionally used in colon cleansing, have been connected to many fatalities. Other less severe adverse effects of colon cleansing include cramps, bloating, diarrhea, nausea, and vomiting. Pooping daily is a must. It's typical to visit the toilet to relieve yourself anywhere from 3 times a day to 3 times a week. It's entirely normal not to use the toilet every day for poop. The 3-in-3 rule, which claims that using the restroom anywhere between 3 times a day and 3 times a week is within a typical range, is a helpful indicator of whether your bathroom habits are healthy. How frequently you go to the bathroom can be influenced by various factors, such as your food, hydration level, age, and stress. Concerning our discussion, you may speak with a doctor if you detect any sudden changes in your bowel habits. If you want to fix the problem, you may use the stool chart available on the net, which can also provide some information about your digestive health. These charts are usually accompanied by a visual graph that can help determine whether you have diarrhea or constipation. The gut wall benefits from a diet devoid of lectins. Ensure that your beans are cooked properly. Lectins are proteins in many plant foods that some people believe can harm your intestinal wall and cause chronic inflammation. This idea is part of a growing and vocal movement. As a result, supporters advise people to avoid lectin-rich foods like kidney beans, aubergines, cashews, goji berries, whole grains, green beans, and lentils, which are known for their toxicity. Lectins have been demonstrated in vitro and animal experiments to adhere to the intestinal walls of mammals and communicate with the cells, inducing an immune response. Although undercooked kidney beans have many lectins termed phytohemagglutinin, which can cause severe nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, very few human trials have demonstrated these claims. You must prepare kidney beans and lentils correctly if you plan to eat them. The FDA warns that boiling kidney beans for less than 10 minutes can boost their toxicity levels by a factor of 5. Instead, they advise consumers to simmer them for 30 minutes. Also, never use a slow cooker for cooking raw beans because the heat is insufficient to destroy the lectins. You should always drain the water you soak the beans in. Almost all foods contain the lectin protein family, particularly grains and legumes. There are a few instances where lectins in consumable plant foods are harmful, albeit this is not always the case. There will always be myths floating around about health and wellness. It's important to clarify and question any claims, as we've done with the diet myths that kill microbiomes. Let's keep the conversation going with a few more videos on the benefits of gut microbiomes, shall we? Watch 11 ways to clean gut bacteria, or 14 clear signs you have an unhealthy gut. Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both videos to learn about the gut microbiome. Have you thought about altering your eating habits? Let us know in the comments below.